this time, before we bring you the action in this film of the World Heavyweight Championship, Steve Kern, who had his leg broken by Sonny King, Pak Song, and Eric the Red, has undergone corrective surgery for the damaged tendons in his foot and ankle and is currently recuperating at the Florida Hospital in Orlando. And the president of the NWA, Mr. Bob Geigel, has ordered that this film, immediately after this airing here on Championship Wrestling, be sent directly to the board of directors of the National Wrestling Alliance. They want to scrutinize the film carefully and interrogate all of the principals involved regarding this highly controversial World Heavyweight Championship match. Here you see the match underway. Harley Race, the world champion, with a salto, and it's Dusty Rhodes firing back at him. Now, as you can see, the ring is surrounded by lumberjacks. This is under lumberjack rules, with a 90-minute time limit. The champion outside the ring being pushed back into the ring by Wahoo McDaniels, Jerry Briscoe, Rocky Johnson. The world heavyweight champion, Harley Race, on the canvas. Dusty Rhodes coming off the ropes. There you see another of the lumberjacks, Ollie Bay, to the right, Pete Austin. Also, Mr. Sato and Mr. Saito and Bob Duncan, as you can see them all, putting the champion back into the ring in this most important World Heavyweight Championship match, a highly controversial situation, as you'll see in just a couple of moments. I might point out there you see Pak Song and Sonny King, two more of the lumberjacks. Of course, there were several standby lumberjacks, including Eric the Red. Dusty Rhodes catches the world champion on that second rope, slams him into the center of the ring. Dusty Rhodes continues to punish the World Heavyweight Champion. The title that he has sought for such a long, long time could perhaps be within his reach at this point in time. Sonny King watching one of the lumberjacks. There's Pak Song. The champion coming off the ropes now, and Dusty Rhodes ducks out of the way. Rhodes in with a lateral press. Ollie Bay pointing out the fact that the World Heavyweight Champion's feet are on the ropes. And so consequently, the hold is broken. Back on their feet, it is the world champion bringing Rhodes up into a suplex. Rhodes on the canvas. Rhodes coming up slowly, coming back into the ring now. And you can see Ollie Bay over to one side, and a problem erupting now with Sonny King. Ollie Bay hitting Rhodes from the outside. Dusty Rhodes running Ollie Bay into the steel post, the guardrail outside the ring. Ollie Bay is down. You can see them administering aid to him at this time, and Dusty Rhodes, who has already been lacerated, as has the champion. The two of them battling it out now in the squared circle. There you see them rendering more assistance to Ollie Bay. He, too, has been injured, and it appears that Ollie Bay is going to be escorted from the ring. A drop kick by the challenger, Dusty Rhodes, puts the champion on the canvas once again. Ollie Bay being removed, and, of course, one of the standby lumberjacks will be moving up to the ring area. This is a 90-minute time limit. Lumberjack rules. Dusty Rhodes now moves in on the champion once again. Ollie Bay being escorted from the ring area. Dusty Rhodes again has the champion in dire straits. Rhodes looking to the thousands jammed at the Bayfront Center in St. Petersburg. And now the spinning toehold on the World Heavyweight Champion. The referee checking. Rhodes knocked to one side by the champion. Rhodes to the other side of the ring, and the referee has been knocked from the ring. The referee is knocked from the ring. Rhodes is outside the ring. There's Mr. Saito, and now the champion tries to set Rhodes for a pile driver, but watch Rhodes upending the champion, backdrops him. Dusty Rhodes turned around. The referee still out of action, still out of commission now. Dusty Rhodes brings the World Heavyweight Champion Harley Race up, a full pile driver outside the ring. Rhodes against that steel guardrail. Now Dusty Rhodes, a challenger, moves back inside the ring. The referee being helped back in by the lumberjacks. Dusty Rhodes telling him that the champion is outside the ring on the opposite side. The referee, dazed, gets to his feet, going over to check. And now watch to the left of your screen. There comes Eric the Red coming into the ring. Eric the Red coming into the ring. And Dusty Rhodes dispatching him very, very quickly. And now watch. Sonny King goes over, picks up the object that Eric the Red had, and catches Dusty Rhodes in the back of the head. And the champion being pushed back in. You'll note now that the champion could not have been aware of this. The referee was not aware of it. Rhodes on the canvas, the champion, with a lateral press, a count of three. Wahoo McDaniels trying to explain that Sonny King and Eric the Red interfered. The referee obviously did not see it. I cannot believe that the champion was aware of it. But nonetheless, the fatal count of three. And for the moment, that holds. For the moment, that holds. And Harley Race does retain his World Heavyweight Championship. But this film in its entirety will be viewed by the board of directors of the NWA. And Dusty Rhodes had these comments in the dressing room right after this controversial match.